Hey everybody, Clay Archer, CEO of DBC Technology, and I've got a good one for you today. Today we're going to take the new Unifi Access Ultra and we're going to throw it on the stock room door here at DBC Technology. This is a pretty cool little piece of technology. It's an all-in-one access door module. So basically it will control one door with this little device. Just like with our front door access system, you'll be able to present your phone to the door and be able to walk into the storage room if you have permission. So without any further ado, we're going to go ahead and do a real-world install of the Unifi Access Ultra.
This device has the potential to be a game changer when it comes to the access system. Currently, they have an access hub that you have to hook up and set behind a wall or up in your ceiling that will control the door access. This one consolidates all of that into one device. So the way these devices will hook up is we'll provide PoE to the Unifi Access Ultra, and then I will be running a copper line for these two to plug into the back of the exit request on this device. So first step I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go ahead and open up the door striker and take a look at the fittings of how this fits, because this is a little bit deeper and a little wider than my current door strike. So I wanna take that off, take a look behind it, and cut whatever I need to make sure this fits in the door. And then I'll probably run my line to that spot. Second part, I'll be running the line to the Unifi Access Ultra and running the copper cable to that. Okay, so the first thing that's hitting is this metal bracket right here. So I'm probably just gonna go ahead and cut that off and see where we fit from there. Okay, we're a lot closer, but this is gonna hit there on this outside wall. It's hitting on the outside line here. So what I'm gonna have to do, and as I've kind of looked up what these look like online, a lot of people cut this extra part of the door out. That way this full side of the striker is exposed. So I'm gonna need to cut essentially back to the end of this point here so that I can sit this down into the door frame. I'm just gonna shave some of the edges off of these so that it's not sharp on the outside. All right, let's see what that looks like. Okay, close. Now we got the next problem that we're gonna hit here. I'm hitting the wood on the door frame. So now I need to cut into the door frame. So this is the multi-tool. It's gonna be the easiest way that I can to get back behind the door frame here and cut out the holes I needed on the wood. You can see I've made the cuts on the outside here, just kind of fitting the same width of this. Now I'm gonna come in from this angle, see if I could just pop that block of wood off. Try to get to here, essentially. Okay, so we're in the cavity right next to this door here. Might just try that and see if that works. Boom, that looks pretty good. All right, next I'm gonna see if I can get this wire up the wall as high as I can get it so that I can come in from the top side and reach it and run a wire to it. So just gonna see if I can get that in there. This is the fish tape. You can see it spools up this direction. So I'm trying to angle it as I put it in so that it goes up into the wall and all the way up to the top. And if you guys are looking for more information about running wires up to the top of the wall or something like that, we do have a video. We'll put a link in the description for that exact same concept. All right, so I need to get this all the way up to above the ceiling so that I can run the wire to it. But as you can see here, our walls go all the way to the ceiling. So there's no access above a ceiling tile so I can run the wire down. But I've got a little trick. Our bathroom is shared with this wall and our bathroom has drop tiles. So we're gonna go ahead and go on the other side of the wall here and climb up on a ladder and see if we can reach this wire from above the ceiling. Oh, got it. So now it's up here. We're ready for the next steps. All right, now we go to the other side and pull the wire back through, hopefully. All right, I got my wire to the door striker. So the next thing is we're gonna be running that same wire up and then back down the wall to where our Unifi Access is gonna be sitting. So I just wanna see if I can check where the studs are. Once I find out which stud goes where, I will find an open cavity. That way I can go right back in the bathroom again and then run the Cat6 cable and the two wire down to that. So I basically just wanna be in this cavity in between these two. So just somewhere right in the middle here. I've got my little box that I'm gonna be cutting a hole out. We'll measure and level that. Okay, our Light switches are at 45.5. So I'm just gonna mark that height. And then that'll be center on our switch. This is a low voltage box that you can just pick up at any old Lowe's, Home Depot. Now we just gotta cut that out. I like to start all corners, because if you just start going from one side to another side, then it might rip out early and fall into the wall. But if you have the corners started all, then there's a much less likely chance that it's gonna rip off and fall into the wall. So you'll get a cleaner cut, essentially. All right, now that I've got my hole cut in the wall, I need to run the Cat 6 line from the closet over to this wall on the other side of the bathroom there. And then when I'm ready, I'm gonna stick the fish sticks down the wall, tape to it with the Cat 6 line and the brown wire, and tape them together, and we'll pull it right all out to this hole here. All right, I'm just gonna track back the Cat 6 cable the same route that the other ones take, and that runs right over our bathroom where we need to poke it down the wall. All right, we got our wires where we need them. We're gonna go ahead and mount the low volt box up into the wall, get our Unifi Access Ultra's mounting plate mounted to that, strip our wires, hook it all up and test it out. All right, so I've got my brown wire coming out the hole that we ran to. I have spliced the wires, twisted them together. We got red going to one and black going to the other. And I'm just gonna mount it right up in here. Got the wires all tucked in. Ready to go. All right, now we're over at the computer. So I'm gonna go ahead and jump in on the access panel in the Unifi Cloud. And we're gonna go ahead and adopt this new Unifi Access Ultra. So go ahead and click adopt there. Okay, so I've already adopted it here. It's updating now. Went ahead and logged into our company's enterprise workspace and then went into the manager portal. That's what it brings us up to this top page here. And then the way I'm familiar with is it normally brings me to this page. I pick the site that I'm trying to manage, and then I click door access. And then I can go over on the side here and click doors. And then you'll see this is the new one that we just adopted. And if you go ahead and click into it, you can now manage it just like you would the rest of our doors. I'm gonna go ahead and rename it. This will be the inventory. Okay, and then we're gonna go jump over here to the policy section. And as you can see, it picks up the default policies that we have applied. And then I'm gonna just leave those applied for now, and then we're gonna go back through later and adjust that to make it a little bit more conditional access to who actually we want to have access to this inventory room. All right, the inventory room has adopted. We can see here, we can test clicking to unlock. Pretty cool. And shows any activities. We can go through and see what paired devices we have here, what other access methods we're gonna allow with this, and the typical firmware update options. All right, so another neat factor about this new UA Access Ultra is it has a tamper detection on the back of it, and I'll show you a little clip there of the button on the back. And what happens is when you mount that button flush to the wall, it presses it in, and then you have this tampering alert option right here. And when people pull it off or they tamper with it, that button will release, and then it says right here, when tampering is detected, the alarm on the Ultra will sound and admins will receive a warning notification. So you can kind of disable that or leave that on as you will. And with that, we'll go ahead and go over to the room and test opening the door. All right, so we've got our Unifi Access Panel Ultra adopted with the blue light. So you can see it's definitely there. Let's go ahead and test it out. So I've got my UI app, so I can either tap it against it or I just push open on my phone. You'll hear a little beep and you can go ahead and push the door open. And then after just a second, you can hear it locks again. Full disclosure here, I did have a few issues with the door itself. Once I mounted this new strike plate on here, the door wasn't quite sitting right. So what I ended up doing was shimming this outwards a little bit towards the door. Right now, if I bump it just the right way, the door will dislodge and pull out, but that's no fault to anything with Unifi's new access system with the strike plate. It's just more so the installers of the door didn't quite sit it right. That's typical for this type of installation. It definitely requires a little bit of retrofitting and engineering, but we've got it all to fit and it looks pretty nice.
So wow, that was a really fun project. I want to thank Sean for taking the time to go through that process. I wanted to slow down in this video and show a real world installation. You know, a lot of the details of an installation are the hurdles that you hit when you do one of these things. Obviously, with these types of installs, everything's a one-off and there's gonna be some modifications. And I wanted to kind of document that process. Sean obviously does this kind of stuff all day, every day. So if you're a home installer, you're gonna figure this is probably a good half-day project and you're gonna hit some snags along the way. But in the end, I got exactly what I want. For us here, that's our storage room, and we have, you know, some pretty high-end computer equipment in that room. It's not only that I want that room to be secure, but the bigger feature for us is that we have limited access to that room. So Mallory, who does our procurement, locks those doors all the time. She's the only one that has access to it with a key. The reason is because somebody will walk in there and they need a 5-port switch, and they just pick it up and they'll walk out, and we'll never know where that went in inventory. So we put a camera in there to be able to track it that way, but that's still problematic. So what this gives us is the ability through UID to give everybody access to that room that needs access to that room, and only people that need access to that room. But they, when they go in and they go into that room, it logs that they went into that room. So very simple, very easy for us to give people access that need access and not access to people that don't need access. And for a room like that, I think it's perfect. Now, there was a lot of comments in the forums about the security. Now, there is a tamper switch on the back of it. I'm not gonna go into detail on that because I don't wanna show everybody how to defeat the switch. But I will say that it would be very difficult to defeat the switch. And in the software, as you saw, there is alerting. So I can have that alert me by either an email or by using the app. And for us, it's in an area that has cameras. So where I would use this is in this exact kind of example, where you have a room you wanna give people access to on a limited basis and be able to control who is going in and out and be able to log when that happens. So for me, it's a perfect fit. I can see that in a lot of professional offices, it would be perfect too. I probably wouldn't put this on an exterior door, or I would put it on an exterior door where I really wasn't super concerned about the ultimate security of what's inside of it. And obviously we set it to fail secure, so if somebody did tamper with it, it would fail lock. You'd really have to know what you're doing to tamper with it, and in all reality, nobody's gonna get through that system. So if you have any comments or questions, please put them down below. And if you would have done the install any differently, you know, like I said, this is a one-off install on these kind of things, and maybe you wouldn't cut the door frame, or maybe you would have gone up the wall a different way, or you have some cheat codes. People do read the comments, and they make comments on the comments down there, so I'd love that to be a discussion about how you would do these kind of one-off, custom, professional installs. So anyways, please like and subscribe, and we'll see you guys in the next video.